'Twas early one morning, Willie Leonard roars, and straight to his comrade's bedchamber he goes. He says, "Rise up, beloved comrade, let nobody know. It's a bright summer's morning, and a bathing we'll go." And they walked and they talked until they come to the lane. There they met with the keeper of game. He says, "Go back, Willie Leonard, do not venture in. There is deep and false water in the lakes of Champlain." But Willie stripped himself off, and he swam the lake around, and he swam to an island, not to dry ground. He says, "Go back, my comrade, do not venture in. There is deep and false water in the lakes of Champlain." And it was early next morning, Willie's mother was there. She was wringing up her hands and tearing her hair. She says, "Murder of murder, was nobody nigh but to venture their lives for me own darling boy. So we'll all go down to Martin's by the shore, hire us a small boat we've done before. We'll row the dark waters all around and around, till we see if Willie Leonard's fair body can be found." See Willie's funeral would be a fine sight. There'd be 24 young men, all dressed in white. They'd take him to the graveyard, lay him in the clay, and say, "Farewell, Willie, and go weeping away." Now to see Willie's sister would grieve your heart sore. To see Willie's mother would grieve your heart more. To see Willie's true love would give your heart. There is deep and false water in the lakes of Champlain. We'll be right back. from Mammy's house. She treated me right well. The hair around her shoulders and them jet black ringlets fell. I tried to describe her beauty, but I find the words in vain. So beautiful that Creole gown by Lexicon should change. Sailor and he's far away at sea. She said that she would wait for him and true she would remain, even though he never did come back to the legs upon Chatrain. riding up and down the street in their big mother hubbards and their stocking feet. Been on the job too long. Oh, now twinkle, twinkle, little star. Long come Brady in his electric car. You know he ain't got a mean look right in his eye. Gonna shoot somebody just to see him die. Been on the job too long.
Stewart on the bass.
You were never any good with money. You couldn't even hold a job. Not steady enough for the office. Not hard enough for the hard. You would rather be riding in Norton. You're going fishing with your split cane rod. You were never any good with money. Couldn't even hold a job. When your grammar school days were over, it was 1917, and you did the right and proper thing. You were just 18, you were never mentioned in dispatches. You never mentioned what you did or saw. You were just another keen young man in the mud and stink of war. You were never any good with money. You couldn't even hold a job. Not steady enough for the office. Not hard enough for the hard. You would rather be singing the Pirate King or fishing with your split cane rod. You were never any good with money. Couldn't even hold a job. And you came home from the Great War with the pips of a captain's rank and a German officer's Luger and no money in the bank. Your family sent you down the coal mine to learn to be captain there, but you didn't stand it very long. You needed the light in the air. You were never any good with money. You couldn't even hold a job. Not steady enough for the office. Not hard enough for the hard. You'd rather be watching the foamers fly, fishing with your split cane rod. You were never any good with money. Couldn't even hold a job. So when the Second War came along, you knew what should be done. You would re-enlist to teach young men the booby trap and the gun. And they sent you home to Yorkshire with a crew and a Lewis gun, so you could save your seaside town from the bombers of the Hun. You were never any good with money. You couldn't even hold a job. Not steady enough for the office. Not hard enough for the hard. You'd rather be finding the nightjar's nest or fishing with your split cane rod. You were never any good with money. Couldn't even hold a job. When my mother came to your door with a baby in her arms and her big hurt boy just 9 years old trying to keep her from harm, if you had been a practical man, you would have been forewarned, and you would have seen that it never would work, and I would have never been born. Proper work in your seaside town, so we moved here looking for a job. You were storming at the power station just before I came along, and nobody talked about how you quit, but I know that's what you did.
My mother said you were a selfish man, and I was your selfish kid. You were never any good with money. You couldn't even hold a job, not steady enough for the office, not hard enough for the heart. And you know it was soon gone, along with your split cane rod. You were never any good with money. You couldn't even hold the job. You showed me eye bright in the hedgerow, speed well and traveler's joy. You showed me how to use my eyes when I was just a boy. And you taught me how to love a song and all you knew of nature's ways. These are the greatest gifts I've ever known, and I use them every day. Oh, you were never any good with money. You couldn't even hold a job, not steady enough for the office, maybe not hard enough for the heart. You would rather be riding in Norton, or going fishing with your split cane rod. You were never any good with money. You couldn't even hold a job.
Indeed. It's been a real pleasure. Martin, Andy and Andy. So many talented Andys on stage. Thank you so much. That was fantastic. Thank you.